This is the second part of a comprehensive guide to undervolt your NVIDIA RTX 3000 series graphics card with EVGA Precision. First thing first, you should set a custom fan curve. This is mine. You can customize it however you prefer on the basis of your heatsink size, fan's configuration, acoustic sensitivity, etc. In the future I'll make a video about fan curves, so stay tuned. For now, the important thing to do is setting one and keeping it constant until the whole undervolting process is complete. Only then you'll be able to tweak it more. Next, you must define the baseline performance of your card. If you don't have them yet, download Hardware Info, GPU Z, Unigen Superposition, and buy 3DMark Advanced Edition. It's always 90% off during major Steam sales. Now open your preferred spreadsheet editor and copy these denominations. Condition, test name, test settings, and test score status. Then open Hardware Info and write down these sensors. GPU temperature, GPU hotspot temperature, GPU memory junction temperature, if present, GPU core voltage, GPU power, GPU rail powers, GPU clock maximum, this one, GPU clock average, this one, GPU memory clock, GPU core load, GPU fan, performance limit power, thermal, reliability voltage, max operating voltage, and total GPU power normalized. Finally, what you have to do is run Superposition 4K optimized preset, 3DMark Time Spy Extreme, and 3DMark Port Royal no less than 3 times each. Before every run, remember to reset Hardware Info sensors, this button, and after every run, fill out these cells. A note, to fill out the GPU clock average cell, don't take the value displayed by Hardware Info, but the one displayed by 3DMark. Click on Results, System Information, Show Details, Average Clock Frequency. For Superposition, leave it blank. Meanwhile, your graphics card should have enough time to cool down. In the end, your baseline will look like this one. The next step is choosing a VF starting point as your new condition. A sensible and common voltage range is 800-900 millivolts, but you can extend it if you want. Something like 1750-950 millivolts is still fine. Since I've already tested the first range, we're going to pick 800 millivolts. But at what frequency? Here, the silicon lottery comes heavily into play, so this is just an advice. Use the boost clock as per specification. If you don't remember or know it, you'll find it here in GPU-Z. In my case, it's 1770 MHz. At last, we undervolt. Open the VF curve editor in Precision. This is the VF point we have chosen. Now click select every point after it. Because these last points must always be below my target frequency of 1770 MHz, it's faster to bring everything down a lot. Finally, use the mouse and arrow keys to increase the frequency from the base value to the target one. In my case, plus 270 MHz and hit apply. This new graph shows that the max operating voltage and frequency will be 800 millivolts and 1770 MHz respectively. You can double check this combo by clicking on Boost Lock here on the right. But you may ask, how exactly did we undervolt? Well, before I had 1770 MHz at 918 millivolts. Now I have 1770 MHz at 800 millivolts. Same frequency, lower voltage. Always remember to save your changes by clicking on a different profile and hitting Save here. In the third part of this guide, we are going to test the stability of our undervolting through a methodical procedure. Farewell for now.